Hello everyone, Wizards invited me into this early access event for Dominaria United, which means I get to try these new cards a little bit ahead of schedule. And obviously, you know, as a red mage at heart, the first deck I'm going to try is mono red. It's going to be a little bit of fun police because other people are probably going to be trying, you know, five color decks and stuff like that. But I mean, I do like the deck and I want to try it. So the new cards we're getting from Dominaria United, I mean, the one that I'm most excited about is Jaya, Fiery Negotiator. It is a planeswalker that very much reminds me of Chandra, Torch of Defiance. It protects itself by making 1/1 tokens with prowess. That also means that it can quickly turn the tokens into an offensive power, because with prowess, that means, you know, one or two spells play with fire or lightning strike later, and all of a sudden you're attacking with 3/3s. -1 exile the top two cards, choose one of them, and you may play that card. This means that includes lands as well. So it helps you make land drops, it helps you just play cards off the top of your library. So card advantage on a planeswalker, always a good thing. -2, choose a creature target, choose target creature and opponent controls. Then you attack with X creatures and it deals X to that creature. So sort of removal, not exactly Chandra's, you know, -3 to deal 4 damage, which is obviously a little bit better, but we're gonna have some early creatures and that means that, you know, we should be dealing 2 or 3 damage on average. So hopefully it's gonna be as decent as, you know, something like Chandra. And then the emblem for -8 means every red spell, you get to copy it twice whenever you cast it, instant or sorcery. That's pretty good. Every lightning strike all of a sudden turns into 9 damage. So, yeah, at that point, you're probably winning the game. The other new cards, there's a 1-drop. It is this 1-mana, 1/1 Flying Haste. Those are not exactly great numbers. You know, I like my 1-drops to have 2 power usually, just to be able to deal as much damage as possible. But the upside of the Phoenix Chick is that if you attack with 3 or more creatures and it is in your graveyard, you may pay 2 mana and it comes back as an attacking 2/2. That's pretty decent for a 1-drop, although I would still prefer just having 2 power. Kumano Faces Kakazan is the other 2-drop we're obviously playing. That is basically a 2/2 haster. On turn 3, that also gets to pump your creature and deal some damage to your opponent. We're also playing Lightning Strike as a new card. You know, nothing too fancy about that, but just a decent burn spell for any red deck. Rada's Firebrand, that is a card I'm pretty excited about. Whenever you're playing mono red, you need cards that something like Earthshake or Kenra, you know, just they take out blockers from your opponent's side, and Firebrand does exactly that. Whenever it attacks, target creature defending player controls with power less than Firebrand cannot block this turn. So that means 2 power creatures are basically not going to be able to block. That's always good. And we can also make the Firebrand's power bigger with something like Reckless Stormseeker. Another new card is Squee, Dubious Monarch. 2/2 haste for 3, you know, not exactly great, but it is very similar to something like Goblin Rebel Master. It creates a 1/1 attacking goblin that is attacking, and that means basically you get two creatures for the price of 1, and you may pay 4 mana and exile 4 other cards from your graveyard and bring it back from the graveyard. I think that's a pretty good ability, especially in a format where Liliana is a thing. Not sure if Liliana is going to be as good as, you know, we last remember it, but this creature is going to be great against Liliana in a sense where it creates an extra creature when it attacks, so that when your opponent untaps and plays Liliana on turn 3, you're going to have the extra goblin to sacrifice. And if they already have Liliana before you get to untap for turn 3, you get to create the extra goblin and you get a bunch of haste creatures to just finish it off. So I think it's a pretty good card. Obviously, it's legendary, so we don't want to run 4 copies, but I want to try as many cards as possible, so I'm going to be starting with a lot of 2-offs. I'm going to be playing 2 Squee, 2 Jaya, obviously 4 Phoenix Chick because you need the 1-drops. But I also have this Defiler of Instinct, 4 mana, 4/4 First Strike. It sort of makes your red permanent spells have Phyrexian mana for the red color, and then whenever you cast a red permanent spell, you also get to deal 1 damage to any target. Previously, I thought this card was really, really good because for every spell you get to deal one, but it's only permanent spells, which I'm not sure if that's as great as I was hoping for, but I guess we'll see. I'm also playing some, you know, Fable of the Mirrorbreaker just to try everything. I was really excited about Reckless Stormseeker previously, just a great card, either a 3-3 haste or it makes everything else have haste in your deck. It can make the Firebrand's power bigger, you know, stuff like that. But now you have a lot of haste creatures. You have Phoenix Chick has haste, Kuman of Faces Kekazan comes as a haste creature, Adversary has haste, Squee has haste, so it's pretty much just the Defiler. I'm not really sure if the Stormseeker is still worth it or if you're supposed to be just playing more Fables or something like that. And there's one more new card, and that is the Shivan Devastator. Previously, when I was playing Magic back in the days, you know, Fireball was one of the greatest cards, especially in Sealed. One of the absolute, you know, most busted cards you can open. And now you get a permanent Fireball. You just get to do it every turn. So instead of just dealing X damage, you know, get to play an X flying haste creature, which is presumably just going to get, you know, unblock the turn you play it, and then just do it all over again the turn after and the turn after and so on. So not sure if this is the right deck for it. You know, maybe it would be better in something like red green midrange where you get some ramp effects, you know, some kind of Llanowar shenanigans. Maybe it's gonna be better in something like Historic, but I still want to try it out, and you know, we'll see how that goes. So yeah, let's actually play some Magic. Yeah, the first deck I actually built was blue green Merfolk because I was very excited about Vodalion Hexcatcher, the Flash Lord, which turns all your creatures into Chris Catchers. But then I quickly found out that we're unfortunately only allowed to play standard best of one. So mono red it is for the time being. Let's move the camera so we can see the hand and everything. Budget commander VIP. All right, let's go. You go first. One drop, two drop. Ooh, okay. It doesn't really get much better than that. We are on the play. We have the best one drop. We're gonna follow it up with the Firebrand, which is gonna get a bigger power thanks to the Kekazan trigger. And then we have Fable plus a burn spell. Oh, I'll take it. That is the Naya Triome. All right, what you got? The Loam Speaker. I think that's the thing that makes mana of any color. Yeah, and then it makes 3/3 creatures out of lands. So I would like to use all my mana this turn by playing Fable. But I think just Bolt the Bird is just almost always a good strategy. So I think I'm just going to go for the Lightning Strike. I don't really want to let my opponent ramp into like the 4/4 haste, lifelink, vigilance creature or trample or whatever that Naya thing is. So I'm just going to burn this, play it safe, attack for 6. And just enjoy, you know, being on the play and enjoy the luxury of doing this. That is training. Whenever you cast a creature spell, create a 1/1 green and white human soldier with training. And what is training? Whenever this attacks with another creature. Okay. We can live with that. So that can block. So we're dealing 6 regardless. And then it's a question of, would I like to play Fable or would I like to play Firebrand? If I play another Firebrand, I'm going to be able to take out 2 blockers next turn. Presumably my opponent is going to have at least 3 creatures. They double, if they have 2/2 drops, they just flood the board all of a sudden. I don't really, can't really get into a profitable attack. I'm going to play the Fable. This lets me loot twice. Actually, I shouldn't have played that land, I don't think. Oh no, they're gonna flood the board now. Yep, that's what I was afraid of. Green white tokens, that actually looks pretty good. The fact that this triggers multiple times a turn, that makes it a pretty decent creature. Obviously, it's a fragile body, you know, 2/2 for 3 mana in a Liliana format. Those are never really great stats, but I mean, you should have enough creatures in play to throw into the Liliana effect. Oh wow, okay. Okay. That was a brutal turn. Kumano faces Kekzan. So, can we really do anything about this? Can attack make one of the creatures not be able to block, and then what? I assume I would do it on the initiate so that they don't really have any profitable blocks, because otherwise the 1/2 and the 1/1 blocks the 2/2. I only get to kill one. If I do it on the initiate, they probably just trade these two for the firebrand, and I assume they just take four. Yeah, that doesn't look very good to me. We're playing this for sure. Oh, I could have actually activated this. Oh, okay. I should have played the land. I should have played the land. I guess I can still do it because I get the trigger from the goblin. Okay. All right, let's attack. And this doesn't block. It's okay, so I still get to do it. I only cast the enchantment so that my timer wouldn't run out. Like it's still, you know, we're still playing with new cards and it's gonna take a little getting used to. There's a good chance they just don't block. Okay, this makes me spend all my mana. I think that's a decent play. I'm not gonna play the land because if I draw another fable, I want to have something to discard. So it was a good thing that I could get rid of my treasure instead. Other creatures you control, okay. Creatures you control gain hexproof indestructible. Okay, wow. Okay. So green white tokens is looking like a pretty reasonable archetype. I don't know if you have enough early drops, like if you have to play Hopeful Initiate, that's never really all that great, but that's certainly pretty good. So this gets to shoot them for one. Alternatively, I can attack first and then finish something off, which is also pretty good. But the problem with this is that I don't really get to attack past the 4/4. And they also can always sag the king. So what's my play? Five first strike is pretty decent though. Now I get to cast Firebrand, or I could just play my land and not take two. I can also just keep it in my hand, actually. Just to be able to shoot multiple things in one turn. But I think with this turning into a haste creature next turn, I think it's probably better just to get another creature on board. That means I have six creatures next turn and I can take out two blockers with the Firebrand. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. I'll keep the land. I could go to 18. That's okay. That's not a huge deal. Interesting. That's probably bad news. Five mana cards are usually pretty good in this age. It's additional. Whenever you cast a white permanent spell, create a 1/1 soldier. Okay. So can we win now? They have what, seven creatures? And we have six. But I can make two unable to block. So they have five blockers. Yeah, so I'm a lightning strike away from winning. But if I attack, this gets sacrificed and they swing back and I die, right? Six, eight, ten. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I die. Oh no. Yeah, I think we just needed to draw a burn spell. I think now I just have to pass. There's just nothing I can do. These two can block. Five, two. Yeah, that one turn was absolutely brutal. Like they destroyed my fables. So I was basically I would have been able to turn two cards into more gas, plus they put like five creatures in play at that one turn. I know people have been talking about the green worm as being the best of the cycle because it puts plus one counter on each of your creatures. That is pretty good, honestly. Reckless Storm Seeker. I mean, I guess there is still some world where they maybe flood out and we draw like a Jaya into more gas. Never really a good reason to concede if you can still have some outs, but it is certainly not looking great. I'm actually excited about the sideboard, which is going to be great exactly for these kinds of situations. I have a lot of planeswalkers in the sideboard. Extra Jaya, there's extra Chandra Dress to Kill, and there's a lot of burn spells. And for matchups where your opponents have a lot of creatures, what you want to do is just board into like this planeswalker control. You just want to have as many like removal spells plus value cards. You want to have burn spells. You don't want to bother with like Rod of Firebrand, and you don't want to bother with like the Phoenix Chick and stuff like that. All you want is just burn spells and the value cards like Fable of the Mirror Breaker and the planeswalkers, and you just want to play the planeswalkers and protect them in play, and that's kind of how you win these creature matchups after sideboard. When you attack, then you may play. Okay. You know what? I think this is a good time to concede. Wait, why would you not attack? And this gets to trigger a bunch of times. No, that's whenever you cast. Okay, never mind. I am pretty sure I am dead a million times, a million ways. This only triggers when you cast. That's a good thing. So they don't get 30 tokens or something. They only get 10 or so. That's okay. Pretty sure I'm dead if they just swing with everything. Oh, plus they get to cast this. You actually do cast it, right? You may play. Wait, is play and cast different? That's not different, right? I mean, either way. Yeah, luck. I know they don't want you to concede in these events, so I'm just gonna wait for my opponent to make a big swing because, you know, everyone wants to try the new cards and nobody really wants to be the guy that concedes on turn three. But obviously, I have no business winning this game. So if they don't attack this draw, I'm just gonna concede because obviously the board state is not one that I can really get through it anymore. Is time. Let's go. Okay. You got it. You got it. You got a lot of triggers. Wow, I thought I was in a really good position early on. Knowing my opponent's deck, I would have played differently on turn three. Knowing my opponent's deck, I would have used the opportunity to play Fable of the Mirror Breaker instead of playing the Lightning Strike because they don't really have any four drops. They're playing the Defilers, which costs five, that they wouldn't still be able to play that turn. And I would have been able to double spell the turn after. So instead of playing turn three, one spell, turn four, one spell, which was what I ended up doing, I would have been able to play turn three Fable, turn four Lightning Strike plus another Firebrand, which would have been a lot better. And I think that was pretty much exactly what I needed, like that little bit of extra help, like that one more spell to help push through for the last couple points of damage. But my opponent's deck looked pretty good, I have to say that. I'll just play this now. They're getting priority, but I think it's just consider, right? Consider's in the format. Oh wait, Fading Hope is in the format. I'm just in like the Magic Online school of like F6. But I guess nobody would really bounce the 1/1 haze guy here anyways. Uh-oh, 2/3 lifeling, all right, no third land, but we can still cast a lot of spells from this hand, so it's not too big of a deal. Rafina. Oh, I can't really get through this. So Fable it is. I can also play Devastator, and no, that's not a good idea, I don't think. No attacks. I was just recently talking to a friend about the fact that Magic cards and Magic decks in general, like everything is getting so much better. Like it feels to me that previously, like you were able to just get like a small advantage early on. Like aggro decks would be able to just, you know, win the die roll and curve out really quickly and then use something like a Burning Tree Emissary or something along those lines for a quick boost early on and then just ride that advantage to victory. But it feels to me that like these days, whenever I play, whether it's standard or alchemy or historic or whatever, every card is just busted. Every card is a 2/4/1, every card is a 3/4/1. Like you don't really get to use these small advantages anymore because every card just gets you back. Like everything is incredibly powerful. And I'm not really sure what that means or like how to solve it, but it definitely does feel that the game is changing a little bit, or the constructed game is changing a little bit. Enters the battlefield at Kanai's whenever you discard one or more cards, exile them, then you put them back into your hand. Okay, so I attack, they get Rafina, it doesn't get flying. I don't really want to discard much from this hand. Actually, like I'm gonna discard the Firebrand, I think. I'm happy if they block. Shivan Devastator is looking pretty decent here. because I get to just play it as a as what a 6/6 next turn, a 7/5, 6/7, so a 6/6. That's pretty good, and then it's a good target for the. Is it a good target for the goblin? Create a token that's a copy of another creature, but this gets counter. So I believe I only get the 0/0. So that's not actually a great target. I take that back. At least I believe that's how it works. Create a copy that... Create a token that's a copy of another target non-legendary creature. Except it has haste. Ooh, what is this? Okay. It gives your legendary cards cascade. Holy moly. So I was hoping to play against 5-color decks, thinking I'm going to be faster, but instead I'm winning the Nyrol and actually just getting owned. 5/6. It is a 6/6. That still doesn't get through Athena, but they have to block it, so at least I get... Oh, wait, but I get to ping it. Oh, I don't, because it has Ward 1, so that still doesn't work. I mean, I can do this as a 6/6, and then at least these get through. Or I can just use Reflection. Oh no, this just transforms. I don't get to do that end of turn. If I play Devastator, I basically deal them 3. Yeah, I have to do it. Oh, I should also play my land. Oh, I already played my land. 5/6/6, right? All right, well, I guess I'm going to have to draw another good spell next turn. Because I can copy the Defiler, and that gives me some pretty good attacks, but an extra spell would certainly help. That's 2 more damage. On the other hand, they will probably flood the board with more stuff thanks to the Joda trigger. Oh, lifelink is not great. Wait, what? You get to do... So if you have all legendary cards, you basically just keep cascading. So if you play a 4-drop, you may cast whenever you cast. So you just get to keep doing this. This card is sick. What the hell? This is Death Touch. This is Lifelink. This is flying. So if I copy this, the chick deals 2. So they're at 5. Then I have 5 flyers. And they have 1, 2 flying blockers. Yeah, I don't think this is going to be enough. Is everything just broken now? Like, is playing a monocolor creature deck just not a thing anymore? That's a big attack. Well, it's getting bigger because it gets a big bonus. I can block with the 3 1/1s and then bring them back next turn, but they're getting what, 12 life? They're gonna be a 20. Oh, okay, they also get these triggers. Okay, never mind. Yeah, that was pretty good. I mean, that's a good lesson too. Like, if you know, if just playing lightning strikes and play with fires anymore just doesn't do it, that's also a good thing to know. I won both die rolls. My hands were good, and I just got completely destroyed. Certainly didn't expect that. Coin goes first. That's a pretty decent hand too. This card might just be too slow though. Maybe I need to be a little bit more low to the ground. Okay, what is this? Flying, as long as... And that is basically a book. That is a wall of text, as they say. Whenever each of your control dies, put a counter on this, then draw a card if it has 7 or more counters. And if it has 4 or more counters, it becomes a creature. Okay. What's that? If one or more creatures... Well, good thing it's not gonna die because we have the 2/2 in play that makes everything exile. I think Chandra's just gonna be better than Jaya's just gonna be better than this. Having a planeswalker is just almost always gonna be better. This can't block, that's okay. 1/1 is not exactly the most threatening blocker. So attack we will. And there is a 4/4. Obnixilus, okay. Does this have crew or something? No, you can't really turn it into a creature right now. I mean, they can make two blockers. Or one and gain 2, that's also fine. Okay, let's see. Unfortunately, this only triggers for permanent spell. So we don't get to just kill both 1/1s and attack for lethal. But we get to kill one blocker, presumably this one. It gets exiled. Then this has to block the 4/4, and they're taking 5, so that's not too bad. I guess I'm just going to kill the Omnixilus with 1. This attacks here, this attacks here, this goes the Omnixilus. I think this goes face as well. Yeah. So we got a W, we're on the scoreboard. Yeah, I mean, I think that's just what's happening with Constructed Magic lately. Like, just playing Gruul aggro or, like, Mono Red aggro. Like, the I don't think the cards are there for these kinds of decks. I think these decks are still playable, don't get me wrong. But you're going to be overpowered a lot by just better cards. Like, just look at Rafina. Just look at the card. Like, it's a 1-4. It gives you card advantage. It makes your card, it makes creatures bigger. Your opponents can't really kill it because it has ward 1. It has 4 toughness. Like, it's so hard to deal with these creatures. What have you guessed? I'm just going to play this anyway, even without the 2-drop, because what else am I going to do? You know, your opponents are playing cards like Wedding Announcement, like all these. Like, last match, my opponent played with 5-mana Plains, 5-mana legendary card that just snowballed out of control. Lightning Strike just doesn't really seem all that great to me. Obviously, we're using Lightning Strike as a way to just finish off the opponents. But yeah, like, look at that. It's a 3-3 ward. Like, that basically kills most of my action here. Yeah, I'll play the Fable. Ooh, I actually can kill it. Still playing the Fable, I think. I think this card would have been a lot better if it was any spell. The fact that it's red permanent spell and I can't go Defiler and Strangle, that's a very unfortunate thing. I could actually finish Sorin off. That's not too bad. My turn is going to be so awkward though. Oh, that's fine. Discard 1. Oh wow, that's a good card too. Okay, I don't know what to do now. I have so many options. I can make a 3-3 here and just eat the token for free. That's not the worst. I can play Jaya, but that takes 2 from the hit. I think I'm leaning towards playing the Devastator. If I kill this. Yeah, I think I'll just take the free value here. Either Sorin dies or the Dothree dies, so it's always the Dothree dying, right? Okay, never mind. Ooh. Is this enchantment? So I don't get to sacrifice this if I sack this and this, right? Creature, enchantment, planeswalker. So I can either do Kumano, Fable. I want to keep the Fable. So we're sacrificing the goblin, sacrificing the enchantment. We're taking 1,000,000 damage. Alright, so what do we do now? I can play my land, play Defiler, and pass. That's a pretty decent start, because then I have double Defiler and I can just start doing things. I can also kill the Trespasser, discarding Play with Fire, and play a Planeswalker. It also seems pretty decent to me. What about just Jaya pass? That's not the worst either. But I think having this in play is probably better. Yeah. Only get the trigger once though. Sure, let's do this first and just pass, I think. If you ever want to play a value game with a deck like this, I think you can do it, but it needs to be after sideboard. And game one, like, I'm playing with Play the Fire, my opponent's playing with Invoke Despair, so that's also pretty big difference. Blood Tide Harvester, that's okay. So now I'm gonna get to copy a lot of defilers. Problem is, I think this works for ability to spell or ability. So I can't really ping it three times because I would need to discard my entire hand. But hey, we have an, oh wait, I can't do it right now. It's summoning sick, never mind. Do we use Play with Fire on the Harvester? I don't think so. I think I'm just gonna copy this on my turn, then play Jaya and kill the Harvester for free. Think that's better. So if I do it, let's see. Copy. Play this for two. And then play both of these cards. No, play this for three. Killing this. And then use Strangle on something. Ping you, ping you. And kill the Trespasser, discarding a land that only leaves these two in play. And I get to swing for a lot of damage, actually. I can also use this for minus three. Three attackers, so I can just kill this for free. Let's do it on the Trespasser. So I'm discarding a mountain, and then I'm playing a Strangle, discarding this. That works, actually. Actually, I should do it on the... That's pretty bad, though. Because then this dies on the backswing. But there are two, it's not that bad. There are two. I'll just try it like this. Not sure if this is actually better. I'm also gonna stop on my upkeep in case I wanna play the Play with Fire. This puts tremendous amount of pressure on my opponent. They go to two life. Sure, they have a Trespasser that can kill Jaya, but I mean, I have a Play with Fire in play that is close to lethal because they're gonna gain one life if they attack. What is this? Thren Portal. They discard it, okay. Oh, they needed to double activate the Sulphurous Springs? I mean, they could have still attacked first, right? They get one life, go to one, then they make me sack. I mean, they still die. Yeah, they still die to my board. Okay, well, this time we actually did outgrind the opponent. That was unexpected a little bit, but Jaya did a lot of work, and so did the Defiler. So that was actually nice. That was nice. We didn't even get to sideboard to do something interesting. Maybe I was being a little pessimistic towards red early on, but it sure does feel like other decks, other cards are just getting better and better. I don't think this is a keeper, is it? And just play a 1-1, play a 1-1. I mean, I guess it's fine. It is a 2-drop, sort of, but it's a 1-1 flyer. It's just really not that great. Can I really mulligan? I think that'd be crazy to mulligan this hand. There are definitely decks against which is a fine. This is a fine hand. Concealing Curtains. Do I play the Devastator? target opponent raises their hand, you may choose an online card, then they discard and draw. Yeah, what else am I gonna do? Excuse me. That's a good lesson, by the way, if you're playing a deck like Mono Red or just any aggressive red deck. Or just basically Magic in general, just spending your mana every turn is just worth so much more than having a little bit of extra value possibly later on. Just like passing your second turn without really playing a spell that just doesn't really do it. That's basically a time walk for the opponent, like with only a 1-1 in place. Sure, there are situations where it's fine to do it, you know, if you have instant speed cards or just other ways to do something, but this just really doesn't do enough. Yeah, I guess we're casting another 2/2. Hopefully we draw a 2-drop. If we draw a 2-drop, that'd be pretty decent, because then I can go Lightning Strike. Oh, wow. That is a 2-drop, but that's not really what I was looking for. Ooh la la. I guess I pass, block, and finish it off with the... Oh, they know about the Lightning Strike, too, so I'm not sure if I can really do that. Doesn't have flying right now. This card's pretty good. I thought about this as like a commander card, but turns out that this card is actually really strong, even in normal formats. Invoke Despair, no, Defiler of Flash. 4/4 Menace. When we cast a black permanent spell target creature, +1/+1 and menace on turn of turn. Wow, that is a lot weaker than the other ones. It's still pretty decent, but I'm not sure if that's enough for constructed play. It's also black permanent spell, right? Yeah. Problem is that they're presenting creatures that are just bigger than what I can do, bigger than how much damage can I do. I think my only chance is just leave these back, double block the 4/4, hope they don't have any more spells. Wait, what? Menace? Is Menace not... Okay, I'm confused. What am I missing here? Oh, wait, this can block. Never mind. Okay, in that case, I'm dead. I completely forgot that this can block. That does make it a lot worse. I'm not sure if there are other one drops you can play. You can play the 1-mana 2/1 Falcon Rat Bitfighter, I believe. That might actually be better. Because it just has two power. That's just kind of what you're looking for. On the other hand, Phoenix is something I can come back from the graveyard later on. Opponent goes first. My hand's kind of weak. Double Kumano without another creature. I'm going to have 2 draws to draw into a 2-drop or a 1-drop to make it bigger. Yeah, I think it's okay. Okay, especially if we're playing the Red Mirror. And now it's a question of, do I go for the enchantment? I think I just pass. Hopefully this is not a 2-2. Hopefully it's the Rada's Firebrand. That's perfect, because then I get to kill with the play with fire. Okay. So now we go for double Kumano. Next turn I go Firebrand, yeah. Wait, does that actually work? Yeah, you just get both triggers of one creature, right? That's how it should work. Yeah, you just get double trigger. Okay, that's fine. We are happy with that. Yep. I was just gonna say that smells like a lightning strike to me. Don't really want to take any more damage here. Already losing the race, but we do get two twos here. Plus either the Firebrand or the Sukkenzan. I think I just want to race. Because this can block the Stormseeker and I can make 2-1-1s. If needed. It's really tough just staying back at home against the Stormseeker. Because every other creature they play just kind of trades for your stuff. Oh, okay. Oh, wow. I was going to say the issue with making 2-1-1s here is that it flips the Stormseeker. And basically, I'm like kind of dead next turn because it's a 3-4 and bump something. So any 3-power creature just straight up kills me. But the adversary is a really good draw. So I get to do this. Pay. I only have play with fire. But that's better than nothing. Because we also get to scry. That doesn't block. I don't think that does it. Attack for 7. Put them to 5. I mean, I guess that could be technically lethal. Is that enough? Let's say there's another creature. Then that doesn't really do well. No, I'm just going to put it in the bottom. And I think I'm attacking with everything. Maybe leave the adversary. No, I have to attack. Actually, yeah, probably should have kept it. Because now if this flips, I have to attack and they go to 1. That's 6. All right, give me a haste. Oh no, and those, they flips. That's 10 trample damage. So I have to double block. I have to block with this at least. Oh no, oh no, no. I can attack with the adversary, which could force a double block. I still survive, right? Because that's 3, 6. Yeah, I'm attacking with this. Wow, okay. Good beats. At least I was in the position to possibly win. If they break on a spell, they draw another land, then I just win next turn. That was a pretty close game. We just need to draw a spell here to not flip the 2/3s. I guess I could have, if I keep the 1/1, the problem is I don't really know. I have to make my scry decision before I know if they block or not. Yeah. Days of Trample now. Yeah, that's just the Mono Red Mirror. Sometimes you're in the draw and you just take too much damage. All right, I think that's going to be it for me. I think Mono is definitely a fine deck. A lot of these cards performed pretty well. I like Jaya. I think just 4-mana Planeswalker that basically stars on 5 loyalty and provides you with both creatures to protect itself or herself and gives you card advantage can also work as a removal spell, although not super reliable, is just really, really, really strong. We never drew Squee. I think Squee would have been insane for something like the Mono Red Mirror. Lightning Strike's good. Firebrand's great. Phoenix Chick, I wasn't really that big of a fan of. Let's see. Not collected. One drop. Creature. I guess you could do artifact. There's Rabbit. Rabbit Battery. I don't think that card is really, really all that great. This is the card that has two power. It also does get better if you play Stormseekers, because then it just sort of like a haste creature and halt the time or something. I wasn't really that big of a fan of the Devastator. It was okay, but I mean, it's a pretty bad like two drop. It's, you can't really play it as a one drop. Later in the game, like maybe you would just rather cast more Planeswalkers. It is flexible, like it means that you will always be able to tap all your mana and use all your mana, but a lot of the time that's just not good enough. Like for two or three mana, you're just getting a pretty bad return on your investment. You could play Epicure. You could play Unlucky Witness. I think the Fighter is just going to be better. So if I just cut the chicks and just play this instead, and maybe just don't play the Devastators, and instead maybe like an extra adversary. Oh, I think I have one in my sideboard. Maybe move one adversary into the main instead. Because that was okay. That was an okay card to draw. And I guess we just play another three. I guess I would like another two drop. Let's switch this to two drop. What do you get? You could technically play Gatekeeper. That could work. Cast an instant source play spell. I think this card is going to be good for something like Modern, but I don't think in Standard you have enough spells in Mono Red. Maybe Blue Red, that could certainly work. Maybe you can build Blue Red with the new Hodigen. Attacks, deal one. I don't think that's good enough. I don't think this is good enough either. You could play Channeler, actually. A spell you control deals damage. You have nine of those. Is that enough? Creatures you control gain haste. Like a one-off of this might be playable too. Maybe Lizard Blades is okay, because that is a good card to pump with Kumano Faces Kakazan. It is also a fine card with Stormseeker. Yeah, maybe just playing the Blades could be the answer. Either way, I thought the Mono Red deck was okay. But yeah, what I talked about, I think like lately it's felt to me that Magic is just turning into a game where the cards are just too powerful. Everything is a 3-4-1, and you can't really play a value game with a deck like Mono Red. Like, sure you can. Like, there are going to be games where, you know, we did win that one game by, you know, copying the Defiler and going for some extra value with the Binks with an extra copy from the other spell, and eventually we just grinded them out. But I think that's just not going to be like that all the time. I think most of the decks are going to be like the one that we played against a five-color deck. They have this Rafina, and that just gives them insane value. They follow it up with something crazy. You can kill it, and just next turn you're basically dead. So I think Mono Red is still a fine deck. I think Mono Red definitely works. I mean, you can build it like this. This is a deck that has a great curve. There are certainly going to be games you're going to be on the play, and you know, cards like Jaya are going to be too hard for your opponent to beat. But there are also going to be games where, you know, you're just going to have three damage burn spells and two damage burn spells, and they're going to play a 1/4, and you're just not going to be able to deal with it. And yeah, like some of the new cards that are just too busted might just be too hard to beat. Not really sure. I'm going to try, you know, more as the format progresses, as as people try new cards and new decks. And in the end, it always comes down to what the metagame looks like, right? If the metagame is all mono black controls and, you know, blue black controls and whatnot, then mono red is always a good choice because they usually play a lot of expensive cards and you can usually just overpower them because before they can really use all the cards from their hand. So it just depends on what the metagame looks like. Sometimes mono red can be the greatest deck in the format, and sometimes the metagame just doesn't allow you to play a deck like that. So we'll see what it looks like in a week or two. And until then, thanks for watching, and I'll see you later. Also, make sure you check out the CMB Pro, because we have some news coming up, and I'm sure you're going to be happy to see that. I don't know if I can reveal that just yet, but make sure you check out Channel Fireball Twitter or the website in the next couple of days for some sweet new updates. So thanks a lot for watching, and this time I will actually see you later.